صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
Adoram Yeshua whenever I leave the house and on whatever thing my eyes fall on.
وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة ونعيما. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة
صبر.
ونعيما.
الله تعالى سيد والله يحب الصابرين. الله تعالى اسلف ذلك فينا.
School governing body of South Coast Madrasa.
أبصارها
وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة ونعيما. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Beloved viewers, indeed a pleasure to have with us once again Sheikh Yusuf Muhammad Kidago, an erudite scholar from the land of Tanzania. Tanzania, a land that perhaps many of us know because of scuba diving. Many of us would know because of mountain climbing, the land of the great and the high Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa. But more than that, indeed a land where scholarship thrives, especially on this continent of Africa. And we are fortunate to be joined once again in studio with Sheikh Yusuf Muhammad Kidago. Sheikh, we'd like to welcome you again, alhamdulillah, for having joined us today on the show. I think today we would like to discuss and benefit from you in the area of cosmology. Once again, linking what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Quran with regards to cosmology, as well as perhaps some of the ahadith and traditions of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam on this particular subject.
Thank you very much. Cosmology, as I know, means origin of a universe. It tells us about how this universe originated. But a matter of luck, this common thing and very valuable thing or valuable knowledge has been mentioned in the Quran.
Alhamdulillah.
It has been mentioned in the Quran. In a verse 21:30, chapter 21, verse 30, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كل شيء حي.
Wow. Already I see the beautiful correlation and the link between what we discussed last week when we spoke, or last time when we spoke about human embryology.
Yes.
Wherein we quoted the verse, وَهُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَ مِنَ الْمَاءِ بَشَرًا. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who had created the human species from water.
Yes.
And here in this particular verse that Sheikh is quoting, the translation of which would be, أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِي كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ. Do not the disbelievers see that verily the heavens, والأرض, both of them, كَانَتَا رَتْقًا. They were as if something that is together.
Yes.
فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا. And then
separate.
We separated them. وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ. And we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has made from water
كل شيء,
every living thing.
On looking at this verse, the basis of this verse, firstly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, something surprising, is talking with non-believers. Why with non-believers? Because on talking with non-believers, something which is relatable with the universe, origin of the universe, can guide them to have an eager of joining with Allah's guidance. And why didn't Allah talk with Muslims and Mu'minun, those who believed? Because they have no doubt about their belief. And in this, the kind of verse showing us we Muslims, we are needed to read, or we are needed to study all kinds of knowledge. That is awalam yara alladhina kafaru, because on knowing different kinds of knowledge, it help you and me to rebuild our belief. That's why God has said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking with the rejecters, those who are rejects the facts. Awalam yara alladhina kafaru anna samawati wal arda, that on the beginning the heavens and the earth were together. Fafataqnahuma, then we separated them. Abdullah ibn Abul Fida, Omar bin Ismail, Abu Kathir, Ibn Kathir, on its translation book, said that كان جميع واحدة معنى رتقة كان جميع واحد,
that it was one entity, one body,
One entity متلاصقة متراكمة في ابتداء الأمر ففتك هذه من هذه وجعل سبع السماوات وسبع الأرضين ففصل بين السماوات والأرض بالهوى, بين السماء والأرض بالهوى.
So originally it was one entity, uh-huh. It was all together, uh-huh. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused it to separate, and that's the question I wanted to ask. Samawat, why samawat? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused it to separate into seven skies, uh-huh. Or seven heavens,
yes.
And sab'ardin, seven earths or seven pieces of land, yes. As we would say today, perhaps seven continents,
yes.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed to be between the seven pieces of land,
yes.
And the seven heavens or the seven skies, an area that is filled with air.
Something to ask ourselves, what was the kind of this entity? Scientists are called the Big Bang, are calling it Big Bang. And it's a monoglobe, Big Bang and monoglobe. But was of what kind and which color? In science, scientists can never answer this question. By this question, you can guess its answers inside the Quran, inside the Islamic teachings. Abdullah bin Abbas, so again, again we come back to Abdullah bin Abbas. Ibn Abbas said that when he was translating this verse, said that it was of al-Yaqut al-Hadara. This entity was of Yaqut al-Hadara. That is green sapphire.
The green sapphire.
Green sapphire. And fafataqnahuma, then we separated it. In science, there's someone called Alfred. Alfred Wigney. Alfred Wigney said that the whole mass of universe was concentrated into a single mass.
So that's the theory of the uniglobe.
Yeah, monoglobe.
Monoglobe.
Mm. Was concentrated into a single mass. This mass exploded and separated due to high temperature and pressure. The same as this verse. But the one who was given a Nobel Award was not a Prophet Muhammad. Was this Alfred Wigney who said, after Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, something very much amazing.
Once again, we see the link between, you know, modern day research and scholarship, and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us in the great legacy of Quran. And it re-entrenches that point and that idea that we need to read Quran and understand Quran beyond just the surface meaning of the words, so that we can take out more of the depth.
For example, there's someone who bore in mind this verse, a professor called Alfred Croner, professor in Mainz. Mainz, you know, is a city in Germany called Mainz. There in a city, Mainz, there is a university called Johannes Gutenberg University. There was a professor there, professor of cosmology. When he saw this verse, أَوَلَمْ يَرَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا, he amazed a lot, surprised a lot. Something to him was very much astonishable. Saying, how possibly Muhammad known this? 1400 years ago, while scientists have only known this in few past years ago, using advanced equipment and in highly technological methods. Therefore, said about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, thinking where Muhammad come from, I think is almost impossible that he could have known things like the common origin of the universe. Why? While the scientists have only known this in few past years ago by using advanced equipment and highly technological methods. For me, Islam is a base and a source of knowledge. And the Prophet Muhammad, I must regard him as a source of all knowledge.
Subhanallah. So this brings to fore the discussion we started off with the last time when we were on set, when we mentioned that the source of all knowledge is undoubtedly Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because based on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala using Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as the means of granting us access to wahi and revelation, we have all this knowledge in the Quran, and the means of acquiring this knowledge was through none other than Ar-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Beloved viewers, the origins of the science and the discipline of cosmology taught to us and shared with us by Sheikh Yusuf Muhammad Kidago from Tanzania. We're going to be going for a quick advertisement break, and when we return, inshallah, we will be discussing more with Sheikh Yusuf. Jazakumullah khairan. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما حتى تنالوا جنة ونعيما صلوا عليه